mentor to this day for many years. I am here, of course, with the incomparable Radio Raheem. What brings you out to the Harold and Carol Pump Foundation event tonight, Radio Raheem?
Well, yeah, I'm trying to be a better person. Michael Buffer is a friend of mine, and he's showing me how to peruse these charitable events and give back. And I thought that this is a great place to start. So it's actually the first time I'm coming to a fundraiser as an invited guest to actually contribute, not just my time, obviously, but some money. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to see if this is something I can do on a regular basis and, you know, do some good. I'm not a big baller, but I can make a little ding. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to try to start that tonight with this cause.
So folks who are tuning into this channel, if they watch me, then they've probably seen you. Big boxing reporter, you're traveling the world, you're in Macau, you're in Canada, you're in New York, you're in California, you're everywhere, anywhere. Of all the fights that are coming up so far, which one are you most looking forward to seeing?
Triple G Canelo 2. Like, that's, listen, we all have our opinions on how the first fight went, all the things that happened since the first fight ended. Mm-hmm. I really believe we're going to get the fight we expected the first time. The second time. So much is on the line. Neither one of these guys, I think, is really interested in talking to me or you right now. They just want to, like, you know when it's fight week and they're like, all right, it's enough. We just want to fight. They've been like that for 3 months building up to this. So the kind of animosity and tension that's going to be in that room on that night, I can't wait for it.
And here is your companion here, the great Michael Buffer, the great Radio Raheem.
The legend.
Michael Buffer, congratulations on your new agreement with DAZN. Looking forward to hearing. Let's get ready to rumble on that platform. A lot of great fights to be. They're going to keep you pretty busy over there.
Yeah, well, it's going to be America, you know, with Matchroom Boxing USA. They're going to do a lot of shows here. We got stuff coming up in Chicago and Boston and some world title fights. And going to be very busy. And the first one will be with Anthony Joshua in front of 90,000 people from Wembley in London, so that's pretty exciting.
What does the energy feel like from the crowd when it's 90,000 people screaming and you give the signature fight? What does that energy feel like coming back to you?
It's unreal. I mean, you know, Raheem's been there and he's experienced it. You know, you're outdoors, it's just legendary. And you know, and you think back to those great moments where Sugar Ray Robinson fought in front of 50 and 60,000 at the Polo Grounds, and just those great moments. Only now they have big TV screens, so that guy that's way up in the grandstand doesn't miss anything. And you know that everybody's hot. They're just ready to really rock and roll and enjoy the night. So, and especially the fans in England, you'll back me up on this. They're off the charts.
What is the best part about covering a fight in England, Raheem? You're out there, you're doing the interviews, you're running around the ring. What's the best part of that experience?
The atmosphere. I'm an American through and through, but those people have something in their souls and spirit about that fight game that's incomparable. They show up for the first fight and they stay till the last bell. They have the best time of any crowd anywhere on the planet.
That's one of the best things I like, is the fact that, you know, we'll watch those fights in Vegas on pay-per-view, and you'll see three fights on TV before the main event, and nobody's sitting there.
Right.
But when we're in these shows in London, whether it's Manchester or Cardiff, Wales, or London, those seats are filled from the very beginning. They're very loyal and very knowledgeable.
And one last question for you, Raheem. I've been a fan of your efforts to bring awareness to these local gyms that are doing great things in the community, or just working with the gym in New York with getting them some materials and some gloves and different things. Tell us a little bit more about that gym, so that if the folks tuning in want to donate to the gym, where they can send their donations.
You know, it's something that happened organically. I'm a gym rat myself, and wherever I travel to, I try to find some place to work out, and it became something that I appreciated, the culture in all these different places. Every boxing community has that, and it embodies the neighborhood, the people that go there. It's something that is infectious. So when I find a gym that may need a little help, where they're actually doing so much for the community, so much for the kids, putting positivity in the streets, I try to use some of my influence to help them keep going. So the most recent example of this was at the Morris Park Boxing Club in the East Bronx. It's a phenomenal place where kids, I mean, of all ages, races, socioeconomic backgrounds, show up there and dedicate their lives to something that's positive and it potentially can change lives on a generational basis. So they got some boxing bags from Tidal. It was very generous. The Haymans donated a ring mat and Goosen. Everyone chipped in that had something to donate, and it kind of changed the whole face of the gym. So that's something that happened recently that really like filled my heart, and I hope that people see these kind of things around the world. Like, give a little to the gym, a speed bag, a heavy bag, something you can do. It changes lives.
So you heard that here. So make sure you look at Seconds Out TV, where you can find Radio Raheem. Make sure you check out DAZN, where you find this man, Michael Buffer, and tune into the fights. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Radio Raheem. Thank you, Michael Buffer.